I think the major factors that determines the value of emeralds are color. We're talking about color gemstones, so that's the key factor. And then we have carats, we have clarity, origin, and treatment. Most of the people today think about origin as price differentiation for emeralds, but truly, like many, it's because every origin has a different body color for emeralds, and because of the color, that's why the price is quite different for each origin. Colombian tend to have a pure, deeper green color, where Zambian or Mozambique has a yellowish green color. And because of the purity of the color, that's why Colombia is more priced or has a higher value. These are considered very high quality Colombian color. So they have the deep saturation color with a medium tone, sometimes maybe a medium dark tone. That's the signature of Colombian emeralds. Where, for example, this ring here is a Zambian origin, so it has a tint of yellow, and those colors tend to only exist in other origins. Some of the emeralds, for example, the no oil emeralds, why are they so expensive compared to others? Majorly because they're naturally beauty, like they are amazing without adding any treatments to it. If you look at these two, one is oil treated, one is not. You can't tell from your naked eyes, they look exactly the same. The only difference is, I think the non-treated emerald born to be this pretty, where the minor ones, they have to add on some enhancements to make it as pretty. Probably, I would say more than 95% of the emeralds in the world are oil treated. So it's really weird, and it's extremely hard to find someone that's very beautiful and also non-treated. I would suggest that you have more than one certificate for no oil emeralds, because the price-wise is so much higher than a treated emerald, so you need to have at least two. So, and the certificate, they will specifically have a comment saying that this emerald has not been treated. So you're probably looking for those terms. A lot of people just look at certificates. I don't suggest that. I don't think certificates shows everything about gemstone. People look at it and say, oh, origin's Colombian, great, great buy. That's not the case. I mean, this is Colombian, the color, and this is also Colombia. The quality wise, the color wise, is a huge difference. And if you don't see the actual stone, if you don't see the actual jewelry, I don't think you should make a purchase. And when you do look at it, for me, most importantly is the crystal. When I say crystal, I mean some stones you look at it, it's quite dull. Like has no fire, has no brilliancy, even though it could be not treated. But it's not beautiful. It's not something that you want to wear. So if you ask me, will you buy a no oil emerald or oil treatment emerald? Like I wouldn't compare the two. I would go for the stone and see if it's sparkling, if it has crystal, if it's clean. Importantly, if there's any chips around the corner, instead of looking at a GIA or SCMP or equivalent certificates, I'll probably check on the stone itself.